You're fixing high school football games.
So what? I was making you look good. You were winning every one of those games. What the hell do you care?
I didn't need your help, asshole.
Didn't he have a life insurance policy?
The suicide invalidates it. You should probably talk to St. Clair.
We're closed, motherfuckers!
All right, the money situation's complicated.
You do not know the half.
The old man wrote a book.
And printed 50,000 copies.
Where'd he get the money?
Any tank. Let's chat.
So with interest capitalized during his period of non-payment, your father's balance at the time of his suicide was $621,381.
How does this fall on us?
Sins of the father, Lucas. I assume you'll assume his debt repayment. $10,000 a week minimum, with the balance due exactly a year from today. No exceptions.
Ain't you the one who decided it was a good idea to float a 500 grand loan to a book that sold 147 lousy copies?
Larry, he has all the guns.
I thought you people were good at math.
But then perhaps I should remind you that I was shown three large purchase orders from Book City Corporate Buying Center, only later to find out that they had been forged by your father, gentlemen. Now, that's not a friendly way to do business, is it? And I hope our dealings will be more cordial.
What happens if we default?
You die. Because I expect the debt to be honored. I'll be back next week to collect the first payment. Gentlemen, I'm keeping this.
So you gotta have some money banked, right, Professor? When they pay you the big bucks in Westwood, right?
It's the Veblen trap.
I don't know what that means.
Theory of the leisure class. In order to maintain decorum, the professoriate spends a disproportionate share of its income on leisure activities.
So stop spending all your money on leisure activities, and maybe we can buy ourselves some time.
Except I got caught having sex with the department chair's daughter.
How'd that turn out? Did you get fired?
More or less.
Great. Good work.
Wait, you don't have any money.
After the bus ride, I have $791.24. What are we gonna do?
Can we run?
No, we can't run. Not somewhere they're not gonna find us.
Can we call the police?
If you wanna piss off Vinny Tang and his friends, then they'd still kill us, except they'd make a statement out of it and they'd use a blowtorch and pliers and shit. No, from this point on, we have to find a way to pay the money back, or that's it.
I have no idea.
Dentist. He's not even Chinese. They're not gonna send henchmen or Petey Wakamatsu to follow us. If we don't pay them, they're just gonna kill us.
I don't think that makes me feel better.
I find a certain comfort in that freedom to maneuver, so.
What are you doing here?
I wanna get some pancakes. I can't think when I'm hungry.
Petey Wakamatsu!